My name is Chief Zachary Smith. I'm the EMS Director for South County EMS. And South County EMS, or SCEMS, is the regional ambulance service for Southern Franklin County in Massachusetts. And we cover the towns of Deerfield, Sunderland, and Whately.
So individual towns had their own EMS service before South County EMS that relied on a volunteer pool of responders at the basic or intermediate level, which are two lower levels of ambulance service that is below paramedic level.
There's multiple levels of emergency medical technicians, the highest being paramedic. And really what that represents, a EMT basic, it's a one semester course, it's typically about 120 hours, and that's just basic kind of life-saving bandaging and maybe providing somebody with some supplemental oxygen. Paramedics, you're looking more at three and a half years of school, and what those paramedics bring to a patient is everything an emergency department would be able to bring to that patient. So whether it's the medications they give, the assessments they can do, and the interventions such as intubating them and providing therapeutic electricity to restart their heart, those are all things paramedics can do that the other levels can't do.
We were dispatched for a chest pain call. And the first arriving crew made contact with the patient, and they determined that she was incredibly anxious. There was definitely a medical issue happening, but that crew was not at the paramedic level, and they weren't able to use the diagnostic tools that a paramedic level service has available to them. I arrived on the scene a few moments later to intercept our own agency, which is I was not on duty, but I came to meet the ambulance and elevate the level to a paramedic level service. I was able to do a 12-lead EKG in the patient's driveway, determining that they were suffering a massive heart attack. I was able then to make the decision to transport to Bay State Medical Center because that's the facility that can help this patient. Had we not been a paramedic level ambulance at that time, the patient would have gone to Franklin Medical Center, and they don't have the capability of making a difference for that patient. As we were going to the hospital, we had done our interventions. We had started multiple IVs. We had given the patient fluids and medications per the protocol. But the patient's myocardial infarction, her heart attack, spread, and her heart went into a fatal rhythm, and she went unresponsive. We initiated CPR, and I was able to deliver a shock to her heart, which restarted it immediately. The patient became conscious as we were going to the hospital, and she didn't know what happened, but literally her life was saved in that moment. She got the care that she needed. She was on her way to the place that she needed. She went into surgery within the hour at Bay State, got the care that she needed there, and was able to return home. Her heart has a couple of stents in it, but it's working as it should. Her brain is intact. She has no neurological deficit. She didn't stop breathing for any length of time that caused any damage, and she's back home leading a normal life. And I think that's the difference.
The best part about the regionalization that we've accomplished here at South County is that prior to our regionalization, each town, Deerfield, Sunderland, and Whately, had a lower level of ambulance service, that basic level. And they were volunteer services. And when we talked about response times and how important response time is, those lower level services, people actually had to drive to the station, pick up the ambulance, and then drive to the scene. And if they needed paramedics, then they would have to call them from Northampton or Greenfield. So in total, it was taking sometimes upwards of 20 minutes to receive that care. Now that we're regionalized, we can combine our resources, pool our resources, and together we can actually provide a paramedic level service that responds immediately. And what once took 20 minutes to get a paramedic to a side, through combining our resources, we now get paramedics to people's sides on average right around 7 minutes.
Now South County EMS has all the resources. I'm able to work at the top of my profession. I'm able to work on those skills that just benefit the community.
One of the nice things about having a community-based service is that when we get out to the community, we can do a lot of things. So we can provide services such as community outreach through CPR classes and first aid classes, and we can bolster our community up. So if somebody were to have a medical emergency, they can receive care almost immediately from the people around them. The other thing that we can do when we go out to the senior center and the schools, elementary, middle, and high school, is that we introduce people to the EMS system. And that has two very big benefits for us. One kind of long-term is that These people are exposed to it as a career, and they learn about emergency medical services, paramedics, EMT basics, and maybe options that they can explore when they're choosing jobs and careers in the future. One of the maybe more important things that comes from that outreach is that now those people, those children especially, are comfortable calling 911. They've already met us once, they've already seen the equipment once in a non-emergency situation, and then if they're ever in a situation where they need to call 911, they know the people already who are going to respond. And they're not strangers, they're familiar faces. And we've actually encountered that a couple times in South County.
Community paramedicine is a new concept to the paramedic world. The concept has been tried in a number of locations, mostly in other countries at this time. And it's defined differently depending on the service, but it's tailor-fit to the community, to meet the community's needs. The goals of community paramedicine are to avoid injury, disability of patients before they need emergency services. So what in general that means is a paramedic who is somebody that's already trained and working in the community that's notably used for responding to emergencies can take a more proactive stance and go into patients' homes and assess, for instance, blood pressure, maybe fall risk, if they have some items that potentially might make them trip or become injured. Those can be rectified before there's a problem. For general public health, dispensing of flu shots or vaccines, or especially on a large scale in a large emergency, are things that community paramedicine can do. For us, it would be essentially defining a role that's very similar. If you hearken back to the days of, you know, doctors making house calls, they were community members that were trained and they could visit you in your home in your situation and make decisions based on your environment and improve your condition within your home. That would be the role of the community paramedic. Certainly additional training would be required because we are reactive as a service for paramedics. But that is the goal of South County EMS. We have talked about community paramedicine. That's something that we are investigating. At this point, we're identifying our community's needs. And in the future, that's definitely something that we'll be investigating to serve the community that much more.
It's absolutely wonderful having our local responders being the people that operate on South County EMS. When we would call mutual aid or those intercepts from Greenfield and Northampton, they were dedicated professionals, but you're right, they weren't from the community. And now that we're a regional full-time service, those are all the same responders that people are familiar with. They know the community, they know their neighbors, and they know the areas in order to respond or get around what bridges are out and things like that. And to have somebody show up at your door who you recognize from this corner store or something like that can definitely help a lot and make a huge impact.
So I think what really speaks to the mind of the investment of South County EMS members, very recently, we were dispatched to a call. Paramedic Timothy Drumgool, who lives in Northampton, was on his way into work that day when he recognized the address of a patient that he had recently taken care of. He responded on his own time to that patient's house just because he already had a rapport with that patient. He knew about their medical conditions, and he wanted to, you know, show his support to them. When he arrived on scene, the patient recognized him as the person who took care of him last time. And I think the patient and his family relayed that was extremely meaningful. And they pulled us aside after the fact to reiterate that fact, that's not certainly nothing that they ever expected. They never expected somebody to take the time, you know, to listen, to recognize what their address was, to come out of their way to serve them, and just because they knew who they were. And that would be, you know, one of the investments that South County has made. We get to know the people that we serve. They come to know us, too, and we do care about them.
I would say the best part about being in EMS is knowing that at the end of the day, I've made a really tangible difference in somebody's life. Everything's kind of immediate. And so people call you when they have a problem and it's beyond their ability. In all of emergency services, that problem is beyond their ability to kind of manage themselves. So just to bring a little extra support, whether it's through equipment, whether it's through training, or just kind of a moral support that we're going to get through an emergency. And then at the end of the day, going home and saying, you know what? we made a difference for at least one person that day.
The best part about the job is maybe the cliche part about the job. I like to help people, and I like to help people at essentially when the unimaginable happens to them, the worst day of their lives, I can hopefully do something for them, and that's the most rewarding part.
I've been in this business since I was 16. I got my first responder. It's a kind of a glorified first aid when I was 16, and then I got an EMT basic certification right when I turned 18, and I've been in emergency medical services ever since.
We never wish ill on any of the people that we serve or for bad things to happen to them, but we pride ourselves on the fact that we've trained for the worst case scenario. We've trained to help them in their time of need, and we're very happy to be able to do that.